Hello and welcome to today's technical analysis video. My name's Craig Allen, market analyst at Alpara UK. Today, as we did, I guess, a couple of days ago, we're just going to focus on the majors today. Obviously, these videos over the holiday season have been coming in a little bit scattered. So I just want to focus on what really most people are going to be interested in. And then starting next week and going onwards, we'll start to try and bring in more of the minor currency pairs, some indices, and also some commodities as well. So we'll start with euro dollar, and it's looking a little bit bearish at this stage, if I'm perfectly honest, although we haven't yet really had any confirmation of it. As you can see on the daily chart, it has been in a quite clear uptrend, but we have seen what looks like a bit of a reversal here. I think it's worth pointing out on the weekly chart this level, which we highlighted previously, which is the descending trend line from the 15th of July 2008. And what we essentially saw is on the day, and this was actually last week, we saw it hit this level and quite aggressively pull back. Now, to me, this is quite bearish. This suggests that there's a lot of sellers. Cool, clearly that there's a lot of sellers at this level around 139. Also, the fact that it came back and then the next day it failed to close back above that ascending trend line, which it previously broke below, suggests to me that that is essentially confirmation of the break below. So that's quite bearish here. And what this has essentially led to is, well, this is really kind of a double top formation. Now, at the moment, there's no confirmation that this is bearish. We've seen a little bit of confirmation here, but if this was, say, a flag formation, or if this could be viewed as consolidation, then that makes that essentially irrelevant. That's essentially a hint that this is turned more bearish. We haven't really had any confirmation yet. Confirmation for me will come if we see the if we see the neckline of this double top actually broken. Now, as always, with any double tops, triple tops, head and shoulders, it's all very subjective. So where one person draws the double top isn't necessarily the same as the other. Some people may choose, for example, the neckline to be a little bit higher up here, which would suggest that we've already broken below it, although it's only a close below that really matters. For me, I've also ignored the fact that we've had that spike above. I think that given the fact it's just a quick spike and a pullback below, that to me essentially makes it to an extent irrelevant. The way I drew the double top today was through using the 4-hour chart and a little bit of common sense as well. If we added this line here to here, which is pretty standard, these two highs, ignoring obviously that spike above, and you can see it pretty much lines up here then with these the original entry into this double top, then the next point of support, and then also the point that we're finding here around support now, just makes this a logical neckline for the pair. The fact that it also coincides with the 200 period simple moving average, as well as the 50-day roughly simple moving average, therefore it just makes a logical level here for me. So if we see a close below this level now, then that for me would suggest that we're going to see a significant move lower. That would suggest to me that the bias has turned in the market. Maybe not in the much longer term, but at least for now, it would suggest that we're going to see a break then back towards here, with obviously just using the size of the move of the double top, and then the same again repeated. That would bring it back towards, I think that's 134.50, so quite a good previous level of support, I think, and resistance, so that'd be a logical move here, so definitely keep an eye on that one. For me, that's looking a little bit bearish. We're just now waiting for confirmation. Moving on to cable next, and again, this is for me, this is still looking quite bullish, if I'm perfectly honest, for a number of reasons. Firstly, we had that break above those two descending trend lines a couple of weeks ago. These are the descending trend lines from April 2011 and August 2009. Since then, we had a confirmation of that break above, and that came here on the 17th of December. We saw that confirmation here on that second trend line, that's the 2011 one, before it started to push higher. If we look at the 4-hour chart, you can see that the pair has been respecting the Fib level. So here's that where we had confirmation, shortly after we had confirmation on that descending trend line from April. We saw it pull back and actually find support on the 61.8 Fib level before springing higher. Now we've added this Fib level from these lows here up to the most recent highs on the 2nd, so that's today. And we're seeing respect around that 61.8 Fib level again. We did see that that small move below, and that came following the US piece of US economic data, which literally now just came out. We saw a bit of strength in the US dollar, but as you can see, we've seen a lot of support here. We've got the 50 period simple moving average on the 4-hour chart, the ascending trend line here, which dates back to the 17th of December. We've got a 61.8 Fib level, so for me, this is an extremely key level for this pair. If we see a break below there, then that would start start to look significantly more bearish, but as we've seen right here, there is clearly a lot of support at this level. I expect this now to continue to push higher. If we see a break below, of course, then I'll be looking for different levels of support. Starting, I'd probably stretch this one out then, the Fib, from the lows on the 17th of December up until today's highs. This is also, you can see, the 50 Fib level, so a lot of support at this level. I'm not really expecting a break below here, but if we did, then I'd be looking at these previous level support around the 61.8 Fib, so 163.63, and then you'd be looking at this real cluster of support here, which comes in at around 163.20. So plenty of support here, but I think what we've seen following the release of that data is the fact that this 50 Fib, so around 164, the ascending trend line, 50 period simple moving average, but also the 61.8% retracement out of this move here, all is very big level support, and clearly there's plenty of buyers still coming in at this level. People are just still buying the dips, and therefore for me this is still looking quite bullish. Finally, we'll touch on dollar yen, and the picture hasn't really changed here. This is still looking very bullish. We highlighted earlier in the week that we've had 9 weekly wins now in a row on dollar yen. That's really, really, really rare. Even on this massive run up here that we had previously, I think we had 6 weekly winning weeks, and then we had a small loss on that week. We had a similar case here. 9 winning weeks on the bounce is really, really not common, and therefore you'd expect that we're going to see some kind of retracement soon. Now, we've started this week, it looks like we're ending this week actually pretty weak. I still think there's room for manoeuvre to get up to this descending trend line. Now, this descending trend line is easy to view on the monthly chart. This is a huge, huge level of resistance. This descending trend line dates back to August 1998. So this is effectively a 15-year trend line that we're approaching now. So do not underestimate how big a resistance level that is going to prove to be. I think we're going to see a lot of selling at this level, purely based on the fact that it's such a significant trend line. Clearly we are losing a little bit of momentum here, but well, it looks as though we're losing a little bit of momentum, but this is still a very clearly defined uptrend. So I've seen no reason at this minute why we'd see a trend reversal. I want to see firstly a break of this trend line, but I think I think all in all this is still looking quite bearish. We did see a break of we've got this double top here, but it's not a big double top, it's double top on the 4-hour chart. If we did see a close below this neckline here on the 4-hour chart, then as before with the euro dollar, I think it was, we'd be looking for the same move again, and then that would bring it back down to 104.30, and interestingly that would close the gap that we saw open up on the 26th of December. So about a week ago we saw that gap open on this morning, and what effectively this break of this a close below this double top would be, if we did see that same move again, would be a move back towards 104.30 and essentially closing the gap. That's not uncommon. It's surprising just how often we do see a gap open on a currency pair, an industry, a commodity, then we see a continuation of the move higher, then you see a pullback where you see the gap closed, and then you see a continuation of the move higher. The fact that that coincides with a double top, I think it could be a coincidence, may not be a coincidence. Also roughly coincides with this ascending trend line as well. And let's just throw on a Fib on there for good measure, and it coincides nicely again with a 38.2 Fib level here. I wonder if it coincides. Nah, it's a bit too deep for that. So it coincides with a 38.2 Fib level of this move here from the lows on the 17th of December to today's highs. We've got the fact that it's the double top move as well, closing the gap. I really wouldn't be surprised here to see a pullback to the 104.30s before we see a continuation of the move higher. But in the longer term, this is still looking very bullish. Okay, that's all we've got time for today. Join us tomorrow for the final technical analysis video of the week. Thank you.